Yes, sir. Mr. Oatley, go ahead.
Mr. Allard, I represent the Ilwin and Perizzolo families who lost a family member in this tragedy. Mr. Ilwin, whose daughter Lucy was lost, is here. Can you agree, first of all, that you were the first city official to at least acknowledge the risk to the structural integrity of the building posed by leaking from the roof and the rusting of the structural steel?
From what's coming out at this inquiry, I would have to agree with that statement.
Thank you. I want to take you, in fact, to tab 56, which is Exhibit 177 from volume 7. And this is, of course, your report on your inspection of October the 19th.
Can I get you to repeat the tab number again,
it's
please?
It's tab 56.
Yes, I'm with you.
Good. And let me know if at any point I leave you behind here.
Sure.
I'm looking at words starting right about in the middle of the page. And towards the end of the paragraph that starts the library tenant space.
Okay.
All right. The words
just,
that...
Mr. Oatley, would you just hold on a minute?
I just need to move. You've moved the microphone away from your mouth.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Sorry.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you.
So down towards the bottom of that main paragraph in the middle, we see these words, quote, "The main roof beam in this area had approximately a 10-foot length of the fire protection material missing from the bottom flange and had a crust of rust over the entire exposed area." Now let me stop so far. This is the what you saw as the commissioner was describing you 10 feet away with your flashlight.
That's right, yes.
Right. So even 10 feet away, you could see that over this entire length of 10 feet, there wasn't just surface rust, there was a crust of rust, right? Just quoting your words.
I'm not sure that I would distinguish those two things.
All right.
I saw a rust, I
All
guess
right.
is... Maybe I was being too over descriptive with it.
In any event, that's what you wrote.
Yes.
And in the next paragraph,
okay,
starting in the second sentence, however, the information that we were given and the fact that there is substantial rust in the leak areas is testimony that this is a long-standing and ongoing leakage problem. Those are your words?
Yes, those are my words.
Thank you. And just so it's clear, your conclusion, based on the information that you had at the time and what you saw, and there being substantial rust, you conclude that this is a result of longstanding and ongoing leakage, right?
I don't know if that was directly my conclusion or from some of the information that was being imparted.
At least we can agree that's the information that you're going to base your advice on.
Yes.
Thank you. Then you go on to say the concern that this raises is that the continuous entry of water onto the steel structure may have had or may still have an adverse impact on the structural elements and its connections. So you're clear as of this point that there's been leakage for a long period of time, but you're also concerned about what may happen in the future if the leakage continues, correct?
Yes, I would say that.
Thank you. Then you go on to say, to dispel any of these suspicions, a structural review of the leak areas by a professional engineer will be necessary. I read that correctly?
I believe so, yes.
So what you're telling us here is, look, we don't know the extent of the rust, but it's obvious that it's the result of leakage over a long period of time. And because there are structural issues here, we need a structural review, correct?
That's what it was getting at, yes.
Yeah. And then if we go down to the bottom of the page, you say, at this point, in accordance with the levels of service policy, we will be involved in property standards enforcement based on a complaint of a tenant, the public library. So may we take it from this sentence that any issues of whether there's a complaint or not are gone at this point. There is one, right?
I think that was the purpose of that statement, yes.
Yep. And you're telling your boss, the CAO, that you are going to be involved in enforcement of the property standards bylaw from this moment on because of your inspection and because of the information that you had, right?
Yes, the entire report is addressed to Mr. Derrick.
Right. But yes, in answering my question, is affirmation that you're confirming to Mr. Derrick that going forward, you're going to be involved in property standards enforcement, right?
That's correct, yeah.
Thank you. And then you say, with respect to the nature of your enforcement, the following. The focus of our involvement will be in regards to answering concerns on the structure as a result of the leakage and that the leakage be resolved. Correct?
Mm-hmm.
So,
yes, I mean.
Thank you. Just to be clear, following your inspection of October 19th, 2006, you're telling the CAO of the city you're going to enforce the property standards bylaw and you're going to focus on the structural concerns and the leakage, right?
Those two items, yes.
Thank you. So there should be no doubt as of that date that it's your intention to make sure that the property standards of the city as it applies to the mall are going to be enforced, right?
I would agree with that.
Thank you. Now, it appears to me that we now, 5.5 years before the tragedy that brings us here, have a city official, namely the chief building officer, alive to the risk of the continuing leakage on the structural integrity of the building, correct?
I'm not, if you could restate that, I'm not quite sure I understood what your statement is.
As of 5.5 years before the tragedy, you as a city official were alive to the risk of the continuous leakage on the structural integrity of the building. You understood the risk.
I didn't see the risk of the structure. I wasn't convinced that the structure was at risk. I wanted confirmation. That's what I wanted.
You wanted confirmation badly enough to go to the mayor and to council requesting a review by an engineer to confirm that the building was still structurally sound, correct?
I did ask for the structural review in the areas where the leakage, and this is the areas that were subject to this inspection.
Yeah.
Not the entire building as a whole, but
yeah,
those particular areas, yes.
With respect to those areas, you'd seen enough with the flashlight 10 feet away, knowing that it had been leaking into certain areas for 25 years.
I wouldn't agree with that, sir. I didn't know that there had been leakage into the building for 25 years.
You knew that it had been going on for a long time.
I was being told that it was going on.
All right. And you had no reason to disagree or doubt all these people who were giving you that information.
I'm not sure that there were all that many people that were giving me that information.
However many people there were, you had no reason to doubt it, right?
I can only qualify that with the extent is whether it was 25 years, whether it was massive leakage, whether it was trickling leakage or whatever. I can't make a general statement, I don't believe. It's essentially, you have to treat it in the context of what I was looking at the time.
Sure, you saw rust. You've mm-hmm. been told it's been leaking for a long time.
Right.
You reported to the CAO that you were concerned enough about it that you wanted an engineer to reassure the city of the structural soundness of the building in those areas of the leaks, right?
That's right, yes.
And as far as you know, you're the very first city official to alert the mayor and the council to the risk that you wanted to ensure was not going to materialize.
I believe I made the statement that I didn't feel the structure was in imminent danger of structural compromise, and that's the information I provided.
Be fair with us.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. The commissioner asked you about this. You had no idea what the extent of the structural integrity of that building was, did you?
Only from the area that I was able to view. I seen rust.
Yeah.
I felt that an engineer would be necessary to have a review of it.
Because you didn't know.
But I wasn't saying there was a risk of that building falling down that day or any day in the future.
You were alerting the council to the risk that water could be damaging the structural integrity of the building, right? That's what you've told us.
I'm familiar with water being damaging to steel, yes.
And you saw the rust?
I did.
You had no idea on the one and only time that you looked at any of the steel, you had no idea how extensive the rust was, right?
Not other than what I had seen personally with my
own eyes. So yes. You had no basis for knowing whether there was a significant risk or no risk at all, right?
I think I had a basis for what I saw.
Yeah.
And in that immediate area.
You had enough basis for concern that you wanted forthwith, you said, for an engineer to review the structure, correct?
That's the statement that was in the notice of violation, yes.
That's right. Yeah. And you drafted that notice, did you not?
I did, yes.
You signed it.
I did.
It's your notice.
It was issued by me, yes.
Yes. And you were concerned enough that you wanted that structural review by a competent engineer forthwith, correct?
Well, that's the way that the wording of the notice reflects it, yes.
And you were also concerned enough that you wanted not just a review, but certification by an engineer that the building was sound before December 15th, about 6 weeks away, correct?
That's what the dates were, yes.
Now, I say it's a credit to you, is it not, that you were taking so much care with the knowledge that you had and with the rust that you saw that you wanted to take no chances of this risk that you identified materializing?
The way I'm looking at it, and in the context that I did the inspection on, I felt that it was wise to ask for an engineer's review of the structure based on what I saw.
Let me ask you this. The risk that we're talking about is a terrible risk, isn't it?
As we now know?
Yes.
Yes.
It's a life or death risk, right?
Yes.
And you understood that, right, from your training?
I understand that if a building structure is compromised, that the risk is a deadly risk, yes.
And God forbid that was going to happen on your watch. Isn't that what you were thinking?
My interest was in safety, yes.
Right. And you had that interest in safety because of your knowledge, right?
I do have some knowledge of construction, yes.
And we aren't just talking about any roof here. We're talking about, we're not talking about a roof made of wood or a roof that's metal clad. We're talking about a roof made of steel and concrete slabs, aren't we?
Yes, in this case we are, yeah.
Yeah. A roof that was carrying a lot of weight, right?
I believe there was a fair amount of weight, yes.
So, with this kind of life and death risk, and I'm not suggesting you knew one way or the other how close it was to materializing in the fall of 2006, you didn't want to take any chances, correct?
That's the normal approach that I would take, yes.
Right. And I can tell you that the families I represent think that's a credit to you. Now, would you agree with me that when the notice of violation is issued, it's a very important moment? Because not only is the owner put on notice, But now the city is on notice that we've got a problem potentially in that mall that we have to take seriously. Correct?
Well, they certainly would become aware of that, both the owner and the city.
As of that moment, you had made the city and its council members sufficiently aware of the risk that you identified that they pass a notice of violation to the most important commercial structure in the city. Correct?
Yes.
And you've already confirmed for us that the notice required the structural review forthwith, right?
That's what it had in it, yes.
Does forthwith mean right away?
It does, yes.
When it didn't happen, what did you do?
When it didn't happen by a certain date or right away, you mean like one instant and
right away
instant?
Or forever?
Yeah.
Or forever?
No, I think I have to take a reasonable approach to the way that bylaw enforcement occurs. Maybe forthwith wasn't the correct wording to have had in the notice of violation if that was not possible to do forthwith.
Well,
which I believe is, it turned out to be the case.
Let's perhaps allow that forthwith was a bit strong. Did it ever happen?
We never did receive a copy of the report under that notice of violation.
And what did you do about that?
I had every indication that it was on its way, that they were working on it.
Well, how long were you on the job after the notice of violation was issued?
Well, from October of 24th of October 06 to May 30th 08. So we're talking about a year and a half, maybe better.
So a generous interpretation of forthwith would certainly be a year and a half, wouldn't it?
Well, essentially the way that, if I can answer it this way, the way that bylaw enforcement would work, and in particular property standards, is that you try to gain compliance by cooperation. And every indication I had was that they were cooperating. They were attempting to address both of the issues in the violation, and the structural report was among that.
Okay. I understand reasonableness. How long does it take for an engineer to climb up in a ladder in the areas of the mall where there's leakage, do a thorough inspection, and prepare a report? Does that take maybe a day or two?
The way that Mr. Cahill had characterized it was that it was an extensive, it would be extensive time involved in it.
A year and a half.
He could have it within 6 months, though, I believe.
Well, 6 months was the date he gave you, and it didn't happen in that time, did it?
No, I will agree with you.
It didn't ever happen in your watch, did it?
I'll agree with you on that, yes.
And I suggest to you that you did absolutely nothing about that. Correct?
I was of the impression that it was on its way. I had every indication that they were cooperating in terms of providing that.
Did the mayor do anything about it?
I don't believe that the mayor had a responsibility to do anything about it.
Did any of the council members even speak to you about it, let alone do anything else?
No, I didn't get any communication from the mayor or members of council.
Did Mr. Derrick do anything?
I don't believe I had anything from Mr. Derrick either.
And
I'm sorry, just to continue on, as well, I didn't get any information from the library or any of the other tenants that there was ongoing conditions there.
Yeah. Here we are in this small city, and you walk out your back door and you're looking at the building, and you sit here and tell us you didn't know what was going on in that building. When you've told Mr. Derrick, before this bylaw is passed, that you're going to take on property standards enforcement for this building, don't you accept that that's your responsibility?
That was my responsibility, yes.
And you didn't carry it out, did you?
I monitored the situation. I was convinced that they were going to bring the building into compliance and satisfy the engineering requirements.
You didn't get the confirmation of the review, and you didn't get the certification of structural soundness that you thought was necessary in October of 2006 for over a year and a half, right?
I didn't, that's right.
You didn't get it, and apparently nobody at the city cared enough about it to insist that you get it, correct?
I can't speak for the other people in the city.
This must be hard enough for you, so I want you to accept that I have no interest in making it more difficult for you personally. But do you now accept that if you had followed through with the requirements of your own notice of violation, you might have prevented the deaths to my clients' families?
I can't accept that there is a direct correlation of the collapse of the building versus the notice of violation and the enforcement of that. The areas that I was looking at didn't encompass the specific area of collapse. From what I had seen, my belief was that the structure was still viable, and I was of the impression that I was getting cooperation, that leakage was being dealt with, and that the engineer's report was forthcoming. It, unfortunately, it didn't materialize. The leakage portion of it, I have to indicate that I am surprised that the leakage issues were not resolved based on the silence I was hearing from the other end.
You'll have to forgive me, and I don't for a second mean to demean you, but I have this visual image of you sitting in your office with your hands over your ears and your hands over your eyes, the phone's off the hook, and you hear nothing and see nothing because you don't ask, you don't look. Isn't that correct?
I don't think that's an appropriate question.
I'm going to allow the question.
Well, that doesn't characterize the way that I approach my job. I took it seriously. I was always concerned about safety, and I felt I've acted properly in this case. Could have been more follow-up, I'd grant you that. But from what I was seeing, I felt that we were achieving compliance with the leakage aspect of it, and the structural portion was for comfort's sake, which I didn't see imminent collapse or structural catastrophe on the horizon or that day or any day in the future. Based on my view of, and it's a sampling view, I have to admit that. That's a sampling of the entire structure, looking at one spot.
So despite being concerned enough to pass the notice of violation or to ask for it, despite understanding the risk, you took no steps whatsoever to find out whether there was continuing leakage into the mall. As you told my friend Mr. Carharris, you didn't go back there. You didn't go and check. It wasn't up to you to do that, you said.
No, I don't believe I did say that. It wasn't up to me to do that. To check for leakage, you would have to have a water test done on it or attend during a storm. And I don't believe that I had the opportunity to do that.
In a year and a half?
I was on the roof of the building. I had seen remediation equipment going or being placed there. I hadn't seen any specific workmen or anything doing the work, but I could see that things were shifting around on the roof. And that was evidence to me that they were making progress in dealing with the leakage.
So if there was any structural unsoundness to the building during the year and a half after your notice of violation, you had no idea because nobody checked, right?
There wasn't a specific engineer's report as I had requested, yes.
The answer, is it not, sir, is I had no idea about any structural unsoundness because nobody with the expertise looked at it and reported to me.
I think the witness has already answered this question.
Yeah, I think we've been around this post a few times,
right.
Mr. Oatley. I think I understand the situation.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Broadbent.